one little mistake, and the whole world comes crashing down around them.
Hi, love.
I need you to hold it together for me.
What happened?
I'll fix it. It'll all go back to normal. No matter what the situation is, you can make it good.
This is a joke to you.
No. Right now, nothing is a joke anymore. You make one little mistake. Eventually, cracks appear.
I'm not believing it.
I was 23 years old. Cracks appear.
Listen to me, you piece of worthless shit.
Don't threaten me!
Then they will grow. I will do what needs to be done.
I had a hard time with this. This didn't really seem like it was made for me, or any audience member for that matter. It seemed more like an acting exercise or a writing exercise, really for Tom Hardy and his writer-director here, Stephen Knight, to see if they could do this, which is an odd choice in and of itself because someone's already attempted this and failed. Buried with, Ryan Reynolds a few film festival cycles ago. That film garnered also a lot of attention. It was Ryan Reynolds just buried in a grave underground for the whole movie, just like this is the whole movie, Locke is in a car. And that film only made about $1 million at the box office here in the United States. That's it, $1 million total. And then, of course, overseas, it only made about $18 million in the rest of the whole globe. So nobody really had an interest in that movie. Now, of course, these movies are very cheap to make, one location. I mean, it's smart from a financial perspective for a first film or, you know, one of these early independent films in your career, or if you just want to try something new, as they're doing here. And they certainly haven't wasted a lot of money on this. So it has a high rate of return, and maybe Tom Hardy's involvement will be enough to get people into the theaters to see this. He is in a car, I guess, which is more relatable than being in a coffin. And Phone Booth, by the way, one of the very first movies to pull this off, at least recently, with Colin Farrell, that did better. That did around $40 million or so here in the United States and around a little under $100 worldwide, with only like a $13 million budget. So, and that must have mostly been for salaries and such. But still, you know, that's better. I'm sure if Locke could even go anywhere in the middle, it would be in good shape. But as I said, I really don't feel like this was made for entertainment purposes. Now, if they want me to come and marvel at their talent and be like, wow, that was an amazing acting exercise, and that was an amazing writing exercise, I think they should have teased that quality more here. I think the quick cuts, the snippets of conversation, none of the snippets were really that compelling to me. I wasn't like, ooh, I want to hear the rest of that conversation. I was just like, so it's all in a car, huh? Yep, all in a car. That's what it seems like. Just all in a car. That's a weird accent you have going on there, Tom Hardy. I get it. You're an actor. All right, but you know, actors are supposed to entertain me. So I'm really skeptical about this, and I have trouble thinking that I could sit through the whole thing. I mean, it would have to have some amazing twist in it. I mean, he's not even driving in particularly interesting places. He's driving at night. There's not even an interesting backdrop behind him. I mean, again, I guess it's done for financial reasons that, of course, you can easily better cut together. You don't have to worry about matching the location behind Hardy in the car, whatever. But again, you know, there was one line in the Unbroken trailer, which I'm also reviewing today, which really hooked me about, you know, applying, you know, the athletic competitive spirit to war. But there was no line here, nothing. Or I guess maybe at the end when he opened the door, I was like, ooh, but I know that's the end of the movie because this is a very low budget movie and its whole hook, besides, do you want to spend an hour and a half in a car with Tom Hardy, is that you will just be in a car. But what do you think? Does this pique your interest? Do you want to watch this exercise, this talent exercise by Tom Hardy and Stephen Knight? Or do you think, you know, Barry didn't work, a phone booth didn't kind of work? Are you also surprised someone else would try this yet again? So write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more episodes right now.